Okay, welcome to the speaker orientation call. I'm Rick from SCP, and we are in one of the most beautiful settings here in Colorado Springs. This is a city-owned park. It's called Garden of the Gods, and it's probably one of the most premier parks in Colorado even, and in the country. Beautiful park. So I thought I'd come up here and just give you guys a little change of scenery as far as like when we're doing this little speaker orientation call. So you didn't have to look at me, you can look at the background. Anyway, so welcome, appreciate it. We're really excited that you're gonna be a part of STPCon this year. First of all, I'd like to introduce, of course I've already introduced myself, but I'm the Director of Interactive Communications here at STP. We also have two other employees. We have James Steiner. He's a gentleman that most of you have been working with on a regular basis. He handles all the speaker logistics, and he is basically our events manager, so to speak. So he kind of handles all the logistics from the speakers and the sessions and those kind of things. We also have Peggy Libby. Most of you have also talked to her as well a few times. Peggy is the CFO and the CEO of STP. She helps with the program. You'll probably also see her on site. She'll be at the registration desk as well. So that's us. It's just three of us. It's kind of crazy. Anyway, so just get right on into it. And we are going to be at the Hyatt Regency Dulles Hotel. That's in Herndon, Virginia, Monday the 25th through the 28th. You can find out more about the actual hotel if you go to stpcon.com/hotel. There's some information on its location, on the room rates and those kind of things. You know, you can maybe even pass that along to somebody that might want to come to the show so they can make reservations. It is right by the Dulles Airport, so it's literally 8 minutes from the Dulles Airport. Don't have to worry about a taxi cab, don't have to worry about jumping on a train. All you got to do is go out to where the hotel shuttles pick up, and you'll be able to take a shuttle directly to the hotel. I think it's maybe an 8 minute ride. I don't even think it's that, depends on the traffic. So really close to the hotel. It is a little bit far outside of DC. It's probably a 45 minute trip into downtown DC. That's without traffic. With traffic, it can be up to 3 hours. Those of you who live in DC know this. But at any rate, so that's where we are. We're really excited to be there. It's a great property. I visited there a few months ago and you know, kind of went around. We have the entire conference space to ourselves. There will be no other conferences in the space, so it'll be easy, really easy to find and get around once you're inside the conference. So the schedule's pretty simple. So it's the 25th through the 29th. We do begin on the 25th. We have two certification courses starting on the 25th. Most people will not be there for those particular sessions, but as far as what you're concerned about mostly, your sessions will start on the 26th, which is when the workshops start. Workshops run on the 26th, 27th. Sessions for STPCon run on the 27th, sorry, the 28th and the 29th. So just remember that. Our first day of workshops on the 26th, we're basically going to start out in the morning with breakfast at 8 a.m. And then the workshops kick off at 9 and they go till noon. We take a break for lunch at noon and then we go back into the workshops at 1 and we go till 4 o'clock. A couple of new things we're doing this year, this particular conference at this hotel, is we're going to have a couple special sessions at the end of the evening, workshops at the end of the evening for both workshop days. The first one we're going to do is the Performance Puzzlers with Mark Tomlinson. Those of you who have participated in this in the past know that it's an extreme amount of fun. People tend to come out of that workshop and say, gosh, I wish I had more time. So what we've done is we put this at the end of the evening. It's of course included in your workshop registration, but from 4 to about 7:30, and maybe a little bit longer if you guys decide to go a little bit longer, if Mark decides to you know, ramble on a little bit, which he can do, you might go a little bit later than that. So that's going to be on the first evening, Tuesday. Second day, Wednesday, it's going to be the 27th. Again, breakfast at 8, sessions, workshops start at 9, lunch at noon. Next set of workshops from 1 to 4. Those are the afternoon workshops. And then we have some more evening activities. First of all, right at 4 o'clock, we go right into the meet and greet reception. And this is where folks get together, chat about maybe the workshops they've been in over the last 2 days. Gives the opportunity for a lot of the participants to spend a little bit more time talking with the actual instructors. We also have a whole bunch of people coming into the hotel that are going to be there for the next 2 days. They want to have a little drink and start to meet folks, as well as additional session speakers will be showing up as well. So we encourage everyone to show up before 4 o'clock so that you can participate in the meet and greet reception. Now that runs until 5 o'clock. It's about an hour. Sometimes they go a little bit longer. You know, we tend to let it go a little bit longer a lot of times. But right at 5 o'clock, one of the most popular sessions from the last conference in Phoenix called the Dominoes of Automation. That's with Paul Merrill and Angie Jones. They're gonna put on their workshop in the evening hours from 5 to 8:30. This was an outstanding workshop last time. People loved it, they raved about it. A bunch of people would come up to the reg desk afterwards and tell how much they enjoyed it. The room was packed. So we're gonna have a big enough room for everybody that wants to participate in that, that's signed up for the conference, can actually attend that. If you're a local person or you have some local people that are in the area that actually cannot make it to the full conference and they would like to participate in just that workshop in the evening, they can show up to the hotel at 4 o'clock for the meet and greet reception, have a little sip, and then go right into the Dominoes of Automation. That is a separate registration, it's $75. But again, it is included with all the other registrations and it's included in your registration. So that covers the first 2 days, the workshop days. The next 2 days is STPCon, and that's when we have sessions, keynotes, and all that kind of stuff. And we call it day three. It starts on Thursday the 28th. It starts out with breakfast again at 8. We have a keynote address at 9. We go into sessions blocks 1 and 2 at 10:15, and then 2 is at 11:30. And then we have lunch from 12:30 to 1:15. Another keynote address directly after lunch, and then we go to session blocks 3 and 4, and then we end up that evening at 5 o'clock with the welcome reception, which is going to be in the main area where all the sponsors are. Great opportunity to meet lots of people, learn about new tools. We will also open that up for folks to come in and just join us for the reception as well, some local folks too. So you definitely want to make sure you check that out as well. Day four, pretty much the same pattern. Breakfast 8 a.m., keynote address, session blocks 5 and 6, and then lunch at 12:30. And then we're going to do something new this year. We're calling it a new post-lunch activity, more to follow later, but we're thinking what it's going to be like are the old lightning talks that we used to do a while ago, but a little bit different. We're going to, instead of separating the tables, we're going to have one person on stage, and we're going to do it that way. So make sure you join us for that. If you're interested in signing up for that, you can definitely do that as well. Just contact James and let him know that you would like to sign up for that. After that, session blocks 7 and 8, and then the conference is over. And that would be the end of the conference on Friday the 29th. We should end up about 5:30. So that pretty much is this, I'm sorry, 4:30. That's pretty much the schedule. The great thing about being a speaker, of course, is you get a free registration to the conference. And what that includes are all the sessions and all the events on the 2 days of the conference, the 28th and the 29th. If you're a workshop speaker, of course, you can attend any of the other workshops that you'd like to. That's no problem. If you are a session speaker only and you would like to attend some workshops, definitely let us know. We do have a package available for you guys. We have a $300 a day package or a $500 for both days. That gives you access to all the workshops as well. So, you know, if you want to participate in that, just let us know. James will take your registration for that as well. So now we're on to talking about the deadlines. You know, this is very important. Deadlines are very important to both James and I. We live and die by them, especially when it comes to making sure that we've got all the materials that we need and everything so that we can actually plan and make sure that everything is ready to go when you show up. The first deadline, of course, is a very important one. We do find that people tend to skip this one, but I can't stress enough how important this is to make sure that you get this in. It's called the AV request form. And the key here is that we have a limited amount of materials that we can actually make available for you. So if you need a flip chart, we need to know that as soon as possible so we can reserve that flip chart for you. If you need speakers for, maybe you have a video playing in your presentation, we need to know that as well so we can arrange to make sure that those speakers are in the room and ready to go when you're ready to go. So the AV request form is out on the STPCon site. If you go to stpcon.com/speaker-resources, you'll see all the information there as well as the form and the deadline to turn it in. And again, that is Friday, August 25th. Please make sure you get it in. We will remind you, by the way. All rooms include a projector, That will be in 16x9 format. So when you are doing your presentations, please make sure that they are in 16x9 format. We'll make sure we have a screen for you. We won't make you project onto a wall. You know, we'll give you a screen. We'll have a USB slide advancers. We'll have a presentation table and a podium. And a classroom there, the rooms are generally set up in kind of a classroom theater type style. So definitely that's something that you want to take in mind if you've got activities. If you've got a special request as far as you need your people in rounds, we need to know that in advance. Generally, we only put a few of the classes on rounds. We normally keep them in classroom style so that the hotel staff doesn't have to switch it out constantly. So again, find information on that at speaker-resources on the STPCon site. And the next speaker deadline is September the 8th. That's also a Friday. That's when you need to make sure you get your presentation in, okay? James needs your presentations to put up on the website so that the attendees can download your presentation, make notes, do whatever they want to do prior to going to the event. Every year we get requests from people that are like, hey, I don't see the presentation from so-and-so. I'm attending his or her session. You need to make sure that you get that to us as soon as possible. It's very important. If you need to make changes to the presentation, by all means, you can do that, but just make sure that you give us the updates after the 8th. We just at least need the core of your presentation by the 8th so we can get it up on the website ready for the attendees. We accept PPTs, PPTXs. We do accept keynote files, and we will convert them for you. Or if you want to save us a bunch of time, just go ahead and export your presentation to a PDF, and you'd want to put 2 slides per page, and you can send that to James, and we'll stick it right up on the website really quickly. So that's also helpful. You want to try to limit the size of your presentation. Hopefully it's no larger than 10 megabytes as far as when you're trying to get it to us as, you know, for email problems. If it's larger than that, let us know. We'll set up a Dropbox where you can drop it there. Again, 16x9. And then when you're naming your PowerPoint that you want to turn in, you want to make sure it's your last name, your abbreviated session title, .ppt or whatever your extension is. So again, presentation templates and as well as the deadlines can be found on the site at speaker-resources. When you are doing those presentations, one of the most important things to remember is be very wary of using copyrighted images. We have problems every year of people that use copyrighted images that they get from Google and they assume that they're okay to use. And then we get a call from Getty Images and saying that we owe them thousands of dollars because we have an image on our site that is theirs. So if you do have images that you want to use, there's a bunch of sites out there, royalty-free websites where you can find photography or other types of images. Pixabay is one of them, very, very good site. But make sure that the images that you select are free to use, even commercially. So that's very, very important. If you've got something with a heavy imagery and we take a look at it, you might receive a call from me just to confirm that those are actually, you're allowed to use those and you have the rights to use them. So keep that in mind, please. Thank you. The last thing to remember, well, not last thing, but one of the things to remember is what you need to bring to the conference. And we deal with this on a regular basis. A lot of times what happens is folks show up to the conference and they have a Mac and they might not have the VGA dongle. And that's very important. We do have a few spares, but a lot of the Macs are changing now. I have a lot of the older Mac style VGA adapters. I don't have any of the newer ones. A lot of the PCs that are out now use HDMI. I don't have any HDMI cables. So you're gonna wanna make sure that you bring everything you need to be able to plug in to a projector. Usually most of our projectors use VGA to plug in. So if you need an HDMI to VGA adapter, you need to bring that. If you need a DVI to VGA adapter, you need to bring that. If you have a Mac Thunderbolt adapter, you need to bring that. So it's very, very important. Please don't forget. We'll accommodate you as best as we can, but we did run into a few times last time where we had extra cables that were needed that we did not have. We ran out. So it's very important. Please make sure you bring all your supplies. You're also going to make sure you bring your phone charger. You want to put your backup presentation on a USB, especially if you've made changes. Then it's easy to give to James, and James can upload the new file. You also never know what can happen to a computer. If a computer goes down, your computer goes down, you'd have that spare USB that we could plug it into a spare computer that we might have and get your presentation running. Visual aids, if you need any, make sure that you bring those. Those are very important. Business cards. Also, one of the other things to bring is a light sweater or jacket, because the rooms can be kind of chilly and some people are cold-natured, some people aren't. Usually when you're up at the front speaking and this, that, and the other, you're moving around a lot, so it's not a big deal. But you definitely want to make sure you bring something like that. Also, bring your smiles. You definitely won't leave those, don't want to leave those at home. This is really, STPCon has always been known for a very friendly conference where the attendees actually get to spend time with the speakers. I talk to a lot of speakers on STPCon radio on a regular basis, and that's one of the things they say they like the most about STPCon is how intimate it is, and that's important. So when you're walking around the hallways, make sure you always have a smile on, because that actually makes you a lot more approachable than anybody else. So that's pretty much it for those things. You want to make sure also of course we're on social media. If you want to do some tweeting and those kind of things, some Facebook posts and other stuff, definitely please do so. We would appreciate it. I'm working on a set of images right now that you can put on your blogs, your websites, that you can put on your Instagram, that you can put on your Facebook or your Twitter, those kind of things that announce that you're speaking at STPCon. Facebook's pretty simple, Twitter's pretty simple, as well as Instagram. It's all the same. We are at Software Test Pro. So if you follow those accounts, you'll be good. Our hashtag on every single one of these is hashtag STPCon. So if you use that on social media, we greatly appreciate it. I'll be looking out for tweets and those kind of things as well, to kind of, maybe I'll do a retweet or I'll engage with you, that kind of thing. So that's good. So definitely, we definitely would appreciate any kind of self-promotion that you can do. Again, this has been the speaker orientation call. Appreciate your time and watching this video. If you have any questions or anything like that, you can contact any of us here. James Steiner is your key contact, but I'm also available at any time. Thanks again. See you guys from Garden of the Gods. Rick Bachman. I'll see you guys in Dulles Airport Hotel. Bye-bye.